We are playing Rise of Insanity. This is a game I've played before, but I thought I'd play it again on live stream because it's a fun game, scary game. So I thought everyone would enjoy it. It contains frightening scenes and sudden increase of tension. People with weak heart and epilepsy problems should not play or watch.
Keep calm. Relax. And calm down. Calm all your senses. My name is Dr. Stephen Dowell. You are here because your disorders started to get out of control. You ceased to behave normally, and disturbing thoughts took control over you. You will undergo my original therapy. I will show you the film I created. And at the end, you will tell me what feelings you have while watching it. And if you saw anything worrying.
Okay, now I played this game years ago, so I pretty much forgot everything about the game. I know there's a lot of birds involved, but that's about it.
The patient's data. Edward. 41 years old. Day, September 1st. I know Edward as far back as I remember. He worked as a gardener in our neighborhood. From the preliminary interview, I got to know that he suffers from a dream disorder. He has constant nightmares and can't sleep well, as well as a memory disorder. Sometimes he doesn't remember what happened a couple of days or hours ago. I have some suspicions connected with his case, but it's too early for the detailed diagnosis.
Patient Edward, test new therapy, waiting for results. Beautiful picture. So we're in the house of a crime scene. Nice painting. Nothing there. Dr. Dow launches his new experimental treatment method. Alrighty.
Tragedy. child were murdered, and the violator was...
I would like to remind you that you gave me a free hand with the development of one part of the garden. Therefore, my decision was to mainly plant the lilacs. I have accentuated them with clementine flowers. I surrounded everything with white poppies. You will be delighted, Edward. Yum yum, toasted pastries. Theodore did well in school. Turn off the TV.
Patient Edward 41, day September 11th. Patient has told me about his dreams where he tries to murder his wife and child. As far as he said before, he's a bachelor and he hasn't said anything about children. It could be some traumatic memory from his childhood. I have to get to know about it during our next meeting. It is a harder case than I expected. Some symptoms indicate that the patient can possess multiple personality. But these are only suspicions. I have to ask my friend, Abraham.
It is no thing certain. Oh, it's nothing certain. Please come to the morgue for identification purposes. Dear Abraham, I apologize for not having written so long. I was occupied with family and work matters and did not have enough time. I trust that you are okay. How is your wife, Berta? What kind of name is Berta? I certainly have a case of a certain patient. Edward, he is 41 years old. He is reporting problems with sleeping and memory. I notice he seems to have certain minor tics. There are times when he suddenly and strangely moves the small finger of his left hand. He told me about a nightmare that has been haunting him for some time. It is the only dream that he's able to remember. He told me that he had attempted to kill his wife and child in that dream. However, he was not able to do it. He constantly wakes up before the very end. He is very strange because Edward is actually a bachelor and does not have any children. What do you think of this? My assumption is that these are the beginnings of schizophrenia or multiple personality disorder. However, you are the one who has more experience in psychopathology. Spooky noises. Oh, that's right. I gotta go to the morgue. Thank you. don't have a flashlight. A key to her heart is located where your journey began. Thank you. Check eyesight room 6. Check eyesight room 6. See a 629. Is that for a lock? Mother and 7-year-old son murdered. Oh, that's not good. Do I go back down? Six, two, nine. No match. No match for what? I can't read that. Oh. Ooh. It's raining blood. Hallelujah. It's raining. Hello?
Honey, gain control over him, please!
Locked. Anything else around here? Doesn't look like it. Alright. Heading back. Where is the border between a dream and reality? What is our life? Is it that what is dreamt, or what we dream about? Tell me, dear Susan, what would you do if you couldn't sleep? Would you be able to take control over the dream that does not come, but haunts you? Eddie is so profound. Certificate of Death, Theodore Dow, age 7. Aww. Place of death, family home. Cause of death, strangulation and sleep.
Daddy, why did you allow him?
is a nice bedroom. Theodore is a very talented child. He's very calm and he has the character of a dreamer. The only thing that disturbs me is the shadowy shape which often appears in his dreams. Drawings, not dreams. It's probably a character from a comic or something, nothing to be worried about. So he draws shadow people. Oh, like that. Beautiful. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Okay, we can't go in the dark places. If I remember correctly, we cannot go in the dark places. Dear Mrs. Dowell, I'm very pleased that you fancy my floral composition. I received your comments and further recommendations. I will plant whatever those flowers are, as per you wish. I will have to drive my car in front of your greenhouse to move the seedlings. I hope you do not mind. Edward. You do you, Edward. Can I go in here? Something. Oh, that goes for this. Can't turn them. Okay. Alrighty. Dear Stephen, my wife is very well, as usual. Let's move to the essence of the case. You should remember that we have a similar case in the past. In it was the case that you took an active part in. We are overworked. You might have forgotten. I think that you should, with the use of suggestion, help your patient to finish the dream. Hypnosis can be too invasive. Try to ask him about his past. Accepting traumatic events he has experienced could be the starting point in merging his different selves. Looking forward to your next letter, Abraham. Finish the dream. So, kill his make-believe family is what he's saying. Disturbing effects of new treatment method. The treatment method for severe psychological disorders by Dr. Stephen Dowell is based on applying strong visual stimuli to the patient. It is aimed at putting the patient in a hypnotic trance during which he stands face to face with his fears and deepest thoughts. The results of this treatment, however, are far from expectations. So far, following therapeutic sessions with the doctor's films, patients have plunged into apathy, depression, or experienced epilepsy attacks, continuing a long time after the appointment. The main association of psychologists is watching Dr. Stephen Dowell with anxiety. They plan to meet with the author of this controversial research. Can I get past that stuff? Yes, I can. Okay, we got the lights on.
Patient Edward 41. Taking some pieces of advice from my friend Abraham, I established that Eddie suffers from a very mild split personality disorder. The other personality hasn't shown yet, and hasn't taken him under control. There are only problems with memory and mild tics. I have to think about the kind of therapy I will apply.
Steven? Are you here? Steven? It's Eddie.
Looking for some figurines. Oh, here's one. Wow, this is what the kid plays with? It's creepy stuff, man. thought they'd all be down here. Apparently not.
Patient Eddie, 41. Day. Having acquainted with the traumatic Eddie's past life, violence in the family, and pathology, I've decided that I will use a less invasive method of treatment. We can handle without hypnosis. The confrontation with the past and dreams, connected with some mild anxiolytics, should be enough. I think that finishing the dream, so killing the wife and child, can join his split selves. All we need to do is wait and observe.
Analyzing your previous letters and observation, I believe that the problem is connected with something. Looks like sugar. The problem's connected with sugar. Please give it some more thought. I'm worried about you and your family. When I come back from blah blah, I will visit you and we will talk. P.S. Send your wife and child someplace. Make sure they are safe. Why wouldn't they be safe? What's going on? Woman receives 30 stab wounds 2 days after child is strangled during sleep. Wow.
Breaking news. As the investigation has shown, the police have established that the brutal murder of the family of the famous doctor of psychology was caused by the local gardener, Edward S.
Okay, we got all the dolls. Oh, it's raining blood again.
Okay.
business. Turn that car on. Sometimes I suffer terribly because I have to restrain myself. When I see you preparing dinner, holding a beautiful knife in your hand, I imagine us together with cold steel in your bowels. I look at your beautiful eyes glazed with tears and your life slowly fades. I dream of giving you a last kiss on your fading lips. Eddie. Eddie's such a romantic. A shovel. Why would you have them all pointing up like this? Dead boy buried in garden. I got a mouse.
Come for me, please. Mom is lying here. She is so cold.
To my kitchen. unforgiving foes.
Today is 28th of March. March. No. Weird case. Only experimental methods. Only experimental. No. Why him? Why him? I don't know. Weird case.
But I'm more afraid that memory may return.
On Monday, Eddie was born. On Friday, he had a family on his own. On Wednesday, his dreams did not allow him to sleep. So on Thursday day, he visited the doctor to confess so deep. On Friday night, he did what the doctor told him to do. On Saturday, he did not have his family. He did the do.
I'm in a marshmallow land. Marshmallow land.
My name is Dr. Spider. I'm a original trust,
control over you, control over you.
Teddy's third birthday was great. The party was held in our garden. All dishes and desserts were made from fruits that we picked there. The only thing that got me worried was that Stephen took an active interest in Teddy's mental development. He's only 3 and his father is already forcing him to learn to read. I have to talk to him. Some of these notes I already read, they're just repeating themselves. Okay, we're back home.
Stephen, can I get into the bathroom for a while? Honey, bring me the towel from the bedroom. I forgot about it completely.
That's not the bedroom. Where's our bedroom? Mixed feelings about our relation. Stephen is my employer and I owe him a lot. I know this is not a discussion to be held through a letter. Let's meet in the garden in 2 days, the usual spot. Edward. Did you just lock me in the bath?
Research theme. The test of the therapy increasing the intelligence among children. The subject of the research, Theodore Dowell. The first attempts to increase IQ, I started using suggestion and manipulation method during REM sleep. The subject handled the experiment very well. I began the observation, and started the manual visual tests phase.
I died. It. Is there a light bulb up in here? Can't even use the elevators. Thank you so much for sending me Dr. Alfred Bennett's publication about the verification of children's IQ. Thanks to it, I have come up with a great idea. I will not let you in on the details yet. I don't want to jinx it. All I can say is that it will be connected with increasing the IQ of very small children in the initial part of their mental development. It will be revolutionary. Imagine this, intellectual elites developed from their earliest age to advance our world and science. The mankind may witness great discoveries thanks to my research. Stephen. Stephen is a mad scientist.
Research theme. The test of the therapy increasing the intelligence among children. The subject of the research, Theodore Dowell. The first attempts to increase IQ, I started using suggestion and manipulation method during REM sleep. The subject handled the experiment very well. I began the observation and started the manual visual tests phase.
Okay, now I can use it. throws a chair. Thank you. I don't know what I got a key for, but I got a key. It's all gone to hell. My entire plan, all of it. Everything was based on suggestion and an attempt to manipulate dreams in the REM phase. I was testing it on my son, Teddy. I thought it would not be harmful that I had nothing to lose. On the contrary, I would be the one to form the first genius in the family, created with this method. His marks at school are higher, but he lacks empathy and has started to be afraid of the darkness. My wife forbade me to continue my research. Why did I even attempt to try this on my son? I'm abandoning the project and sending your materials back. Thank you for them. I will not need them anymore. P.S. I might have an interesting patient soon. Regards, Steven. Can't get past this chair. The chair has thwarted me. Everything's so pretty. strange scenes and sessions with Teddy have allowed to obtain outcomes that my husband so strongly desired. Is a toxic father-son relation worth it? Teddy is no longer as happy as he had been before. He had become very afraid of darkness. On the one hand, this is normal at his age. I truly don't know. I can only rely on Eddie, but he seems strange recently. I've been trying to improve my marriage, but the complete lack of Steven's interest is just killing me. He's constantly talking about his new treatment method. I feel imprisoned in this relationship. I cannot see any future for it. I know it's a bit reckless, but I'm beginning to feel freer with Eddie. I enjoy the interest that only he is giving me. Maybe I should do something else. I guess I need paddles. Where are those at? Oh, here they are. There's one. I need another one. Back in Marshmallow Land.
Therapy increasing the intelligence among children.
Intelligence among children. The subject handled the experiment very well. And hereby open the trial against Edward about Susan Dowell. And hereby open the trial against Edward.
I'm live. the case of murder of Susan and Theodore. After many attempts to make contact with the suspect, we still do not have any information. The accused is constantly smiling and instinctively repeating the sentence that reads, "The nightmares have stopped." His gaze is absent. He does not maintain eye contact with the He probably does not make anything of the position that he's in. Without the presence of a forensic psychologist, we're not able to obtain more information. It is assumed that the case will be closed with an insanity plea. Cause I'm crazy.
Good. So maybe you would tell us about your authorial therapy. What do you think, Mr. Dow? Can you hear me? It's better now, isn't it? So, can we continue? Great. Did you know that Susan Dow was pregnant?
Thanks to Vanessa, we have managed to come into contact with the suspect. It has been established that he is single. He worked as a gardener for the Dow family. He said that for the last months he has been taking part in therapy, and that it was to cure him from his split personality disorder. He admitted that he had killed his wife and child, but, as he emphasized, he had done it in his dream because Dr. Dowell had told him to do so. It had been part of his therapy. We have finally figured it out. It is necessary to speak with Dr. Dowell. John, I know that tomorrow is Bowman's shift, so I hidden the key for the door switches in a safe place. Don't tell him anything. Let's drive him nuts for a while. So you hit the key. But where did you hide the key? Witness, Stephen, the suspect is shocked. There is no rational contact with him. He is understandable in his position. He hasn't said anything new. After the murder, there were many different comments from the psychology world and the press. The witness has only mentioned that his therapy for curing a mental split disorder has been very ineffective. He hasn't commented on that. I don't know the combo. Give me a combo. Is there a combo? Really? Morse code? This is what you're gonna do to me? Three, two, seven. That's what I heard, 327. 3, 2, 7. Oh, there we go. Got a key. Key that goes to nothing.
Listen, Bowman, give me some creeps, Doctor. I won't manage alone.
The examination conducted by Dr. Maslow's team should not be taken into consideration during the investigation. Dr. Maslow could influence the examination in order to help his friend, Dr. Bandura. Dr. Dahl was known for his controversial methods of treatment and the is fact that what? In the past he has probably led to a patient's death. Sir, I am innocent of everything.
I hereby open the trial against Edward about Susan Dowell and Theodore Dowell's murder. Do the prosecutor and counsel wish to say anything before the trial is started?
I would like to enclose the report about my client's insanity to the evidence, as well as recordings made by Dr. Dowell during the therapy.
Mr. Edward, could you tell us about the relation that was between you and Mrs. Susan Dowell, Dr. Stephen Dowell's wife, that tried to cure you? I would like to enclose documents from Susan Dowell's autopsy to the evidence. Basing on these, Your Honor, as well as the jury can get to know that the victim was pregnant with the defendant.
After the appearance of new evidence, which is Susan Dowell's autopsy protocol, we have come to know that she was in the first month of pregnancy. Furthermore, the father of the child is suspect Edward Fleble. We have established that Stephen had a motive and the skills to manipulate Edward. During interrogation, the suspect showed lack of contact with his interlocutors. What is an interlocutor? I've never heard of that word. He experienced ambivalent states, from hysteria attacks to complete apathy. During interrogation, the accompanying psychologist came up with a thesis about Mr. Dowell's insanity, which might have been caused by many traumatic experiences in a short period of time.
I opened the trial against Stephen Dowell about malpractice against Edward. Caused Susan and Theodore Dowell's death. Did the prosecutor and counsel wish to say anything before the trial is started?
My client, as a doctor, always takes care about patients' welfare. In the enclosed evidence, Your Honor may read about many difficult cases that have been cured by the defendant. He was trying to cure his protege at any cost to ease the pain.
I would like to enclose to the evidence the description of one therapy conducted by the defendant, which, as we can read, also finished with a failure. The girl, with similar illness like Edward, who under the influence of the therapy made suicide.
And did the defendant realize that his wife was pregnant? Not with him, but with Edward?
Call me to the stand? Tragic events from my friend's past had a very bad influence on his mental health condition, says Dr. Abraham, friend of the accused suspect of manipulating Dr. Stephen Dowell, which turn has led him to murder his family. Am I in a mental hospital? I've been in mental hospitals. They're not this
Steven,
nice.
Can I see you in my office?
No, you may not. Waller family is the one responsible for the commission of all the horrible acts.
How are you feeling today? Everything's okay? I think it's time to show you something. Let's go to the next room. Have a seat and make yourself comfortable.
Okay. The next room. I can't have a seat.
Our relationship started to pass away suddenly. Stephen treated me like a lodger, unwanted person, with whom he lived because it was a kind of interest. And I started to live on memories and projections that were so beautiful in my head, so perfect. Stephen was in them like years before, like when we moved into our new house and we planned to make a big garden only for us. These memories made me stronger, helped me to survive and wait for tomorrow with hope. First time, I thought that maybe I'm only dreaming, or the projections about him became ridiculously strong. He came to me like before, smiling, happy, with sparkles in his eyes. Similar situations repeated in the next weeks, and I, instead of looking for their source, was waiting till my loving Stephen came back, just for a while. To feel like before, like years ago. At the beginning of our relationship, Stephen often told me about interesting things from the psychology ward. During his studies, he met with the case of a patient with multiple personalities. I remember well this case because it seemed to be very exciting. So many different personalities in one body that differ in IQ, beliefs, talents, and even visual acuity. I hid my husband's illness to meet his second personality, to feel happy just for a while, to fulfill my dreams. During our romance, we often met in the garden. Today, I again talked with Eddie. He is in very bad condition. Stephen's therapy started to even scare him, he says. He must make terrible things to be cured and finally take a breath. As a last resort, I will send this recording to Abraham.
Arthas! We are getting to the pinnacle of the game here. We found out that our dear doctor has split personalities. He is both Steven and Eddie. Music is nice. So they were the same person. The doctor and the gardener were the same person. The gardener killed the family. The doctor killed his own family. The doctor was trying to treat himself. Personally, love this game. I love the story. This is my third time playing it. Even though I played it a long time ago and really didn't remember too much of what to do and where to go. So it was like playing it all over again for me. But while playing it, I did start recalling like what the plot was. But I hope you all enjoyed it as much as I did. And yeah, the ending song is really pretty. I wasn't really paying attention to what the song was. But thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I love it. And I will see you next time when I play another spooky game. Bye, guys.